Hey guys, it's Matt with Atlas Precision Consulting again. In this video, we're going to talk about published lead time, which differs from average lead time in the fact that it's something that you can manually put in there and the system will use that over the system calculated average lead time. We've posted another video about the average lead time. Go check that out if you haven't checked it out yet. But in this one, we're going to do the published lead time. So you can currently see right now, this average lead time for this item is 13 days, which is reflected here in our purchase stock card. Now, the published lead time allows you to override that data. The downside to using published lead time, it's a manual process and it's at each item location combination. So there's not a way to go into supplier maintenance and say, I want everything from this item to use this published lead time. At least not out of the box P21. You may be able to accomplish that with a business rule or something else. But to show you how it works, vendor contacts us, says, hey, we're having an extra lag on this. It's going to be 45 days lead time on this product. So I've changed to my published lead time to 45 days. Now, when I come back in here and I'm going to refresh this data, I've gone from the 13 days to the 45 days, and that has also affected my calculated order point. So again, the important thing to remember, this is a manual process. If you set it, you could forget it. There is no way to do a complete supplier and every item out of the box without doing some kind of form of mass update or some other way to do an update of a lot of records or creating a business rule of some kind. If you guys have any more questions about this or other topics you want to see us do videos on, put it down in the comments below. Make sure you like and subscribe, and Atlas will be here for your P21 needs. Thanks, guys.